Good evening, traders. July 19, 2022, after a day of three-year bear face rally, right? So I hope you did great today. We had an amazing day in the VIP room today with the several tickets that we play. Actually, some of them that we discussed yesterday on the yesterday video, CBS. Work very well for us. Today we also play a couple of good plays on SPX. Chpt did great with a couple of bottoms that he got in the afternoon, and in general we did great. So if you are interested in follow and trading with those live, please go and out the information that you can see below, and you can find where our Discord server is and our VIP membership. So come to business, let's get what we have with the spike today. So as you can see, after yesterday's decline, today we opened with a gap up that was a gap up and continuation. We broke this level that was very important. It was not exactly a weekly breakout, but it was a range that I had on the weekly chart, and it was interesting because after all this consolidation, we finally broke it, and we almost touched the 50 MA on the daily. So we broke this triangle that we were doing the past days and weeks on this range, and as you can see, we almost are there, coming back to these Fibonacci levels from this low to this high here. We actually held the 61.8 several times. Now we broke it, and we're going directly to my 10% target of my extension. And we also have a gap fill here. So today I'm probably looking for some consolidation at the opening, probably trying to, if not to fill that gap, at least we have that this support and the 10% target pending. So probably we can have another opportunity to at least touch the 50 MA. So I have for you three opportunities or trade ideas, very similar patterns actually. The first one that I have for you is Shak. Those who like burgers, as you can see, all these underlines have been suffering for a long time, right? So we're trying to see some type of a bottom at least in this underline that I'm about to show you through the chart. So after this break range that we had on last week, we finally broke the range. At continuation, we have another bear bull flag here of 3 days of consolidation and an inside candle, which I am very interested. We have the inside candle, I have the downtrend from the highs actually. It's not up from the highs, but it's an important high that we had previously before this gap down on earnings. We don't have earnings ahead, so it looks good for me if we play the inside candle break to the upside. So I will be looking here for a, and this is the way that I know when to get in. I just set an alert above to alert me on a break on the inside candles, and the level is 46.90. Actually, and of course our first target always is the previous candle high, 47.42. But as you can see, we have some some range to go to all the way to 48, 36. I don't know if it's tomorrow, but at least by the end of the week. But the important thing is to see the break, right? Another important thing is that we already confirmed about the 50 MA on the daily, and we're good to go to get something back of what this underline has lost in the past months, right? So we cannot set just, I don't think that this will trigger, but you never know, right? So we're gonna set the two alerts here to the downside, 44.79, and our first target will be the previous low, and up to the upside, the break will be 46.89, targeting 47.42, then 48.36. So that is the first one, check. Second one that I have, and I've been monitoring in the past days as well, is Walmart. As you can see, very similar patterns as well, in the sense that it's also after a range break, some consolidation as well. And we have this downtrend that is also about to be broken. So after this consolidation here, and also confirming and holding about the 50 MA, I'm looking for a break of 129.97, let's say 130. And the next target that we have here is, we have a very small gap to fill here, but we have this beautiful range that I'm interested here, that could be very interesting. Probably we have a midpoint here. So after a break of 130.20, we can see 130.131 and 133.80. Most of the time Walmart moves very slowly, but when it breaks and it has range, like in these previous days, it gets interesting, right? And we can see in this area, there's a lot of, there's not too much volume. We should have here some air pocket that after this break, we could have a more accelerating move to the upside. So that is the other one. So repeating is 130 on the break on the upside, targeting 130.130, 133.80, and to the downside, 128.60. There's not much to range for the next target to the downside. We have a lot of congestion here with all this consolidation and our EMA, so I wouldn't be very interested in playing it to the downside. So even though I'm having my efforts on both sides, I'm looking more for the upside. So that is Walmart. Another one, this one, it looks great as well. Unfortunately, the options are not for everybody, right? So you have to see how the spreads are tomorrow, and they're not cheap because they're monthly. So, but anyway, it has a very similar pattern again. A downtrend that is about to be broken, above 50 MA confirmation, about to break this this consolidation for the past 3 days after a major breakout of this wide range. So for Wolf, I'll be looking for 77.56 to the breakup, targeting 79.01 and 81.77 area, probably if it gets good volume, we can even catch a 85.39. So very similar, as you can see here, well, on the hourly, we have some disconsolidation, this flag that is, it's not exactly a flag, but it's a symmetric triangle that we're having here that also is informing. But at the end of the day, what is important here is that we've been having consolidation on the hourly and obviously on the previous 3 days. So Wolf is another one. This one was from yesterday. I don't know if I mentioned it, I cannot recall, but it was included. It was not exactly an inside candle, but it was a possible breakout. Not yet confirmed, but now we have an inside candle, right? So now that this looks very interesting, and again, I'm gonna move here my alert to the breakout here. I'm looking for a breakout on 285.10, let's say 285.10, and this one has very nice range, no? So our target will be all the way up to 295.50, which makes it very attractive. On the downside, not very interesting at all on the upside, because we have a first target hitting mostly in the previous low, very close to 285 from the 285.93 break. Still almost a dollar, but and after that we broke that, we have this range 22.25, but it looks that is respected in the uptrend, as you can see on the daily here. We have that uptrend being respected in the meantime above all the EMAs, just making some nice consolidations, just trying to go to the, and this one on the opposite side, it's on the highs also. I don't know if it's probably all time highs, right? Yeah, might be. So this is the all time highs 306.08. So we still have room before the all time highs, but we just had this big, huge V shape, and so the risk of a double bottom will be around this area. And if we break that double bottom, you can imagine. But right now, what we're playing is before the double bottom, right? So trying to look for 296.92. If it breaks more, even better. But I think it's still a good option to continue watching it. Now it's totally different from yesterday in terms that. Now we have an inside candle, so now we're playing the previous almost an outside candle on the previous day, not exactly, because it was inside this one on the lower side from the previous day. So I have some Fibonacci levels here to, where you can see the possible target that we might get, 295.50, we might be targeting between 299 and 300. So it looks very, very interesting. A lot of consolidation as well. If this range doesn't break, at least we have the top of the previous candle, right? And last one, CHPT. This one is a very nice to play it because there are cheap contracts there. You can buy several contracts. Has nice range. So very similar pattern as the previous first three, where in this case our main downtrend is far away, but we have another one here. Actually, we can see it from here, from this previous high. That is actually was, we might say it has been broken already and confirmed today, and we have this inside candle. So I'm looking for a break of 1286, targeting 1327, and probably you can look for another mid target around this peak that we have here, 1362 and 14. So very nice, a small cap underlined with good volume and good sometimes the spreads are also interesting. So that's what I have for you today, guys, as a trade idea. Hope you have a wonderful trading day tomorrow, and don't forget to like this video and join us in the VIP room. See you tomorrow. Adios.